If you're wondering whether to go with a combined water tube and fire tube boiler with a single steam drum or a two-drum water tube boiler, then this is exactly the video you need to watch. Hello and warm greetings to all of you. It's such a pleasure to welcome you back to another video on DIVI's channel. I'm Pius, CEO of DIVI Group. People often call me Pius the Boiler Guy, and for many years now, I've had only one profession, breathing life into industrial boilers. Recently, I received a question from one of our viewers on DIVI's channel, and it goes like this. Mr. Pius, could you explain to me when we should use a combined water tube and fire tube boiler with one steam drum, and when to use a two-drum water tube boiler? That's a very interesting question, and I'd like to take this opportunity to share my answer with you. I'm sure many of you already have a general understanding of what a combined water tube and fire tube boiler with a single steam drum is and what a two-drum water tube boiler looks like, right? Let me explain again for clarity. The combined water tube and fire tube boiler with a single steam drum is a type of fluidized bed boiler in which the radiant heat transfer section is constructed from steam generating water tubes arranged to surround the combustion chamber. The convective heat transfer section consists of fire tube bundles, which are submerged in water, and the flue gas flows inside the tubes. This boiler is designed with one large steam drum, and all the fire tubes are positioned inside that drum. Meanwhile, the two-drum water tube boiler is also a fluidized bed boiler, where the radiant section is similarly constructed from water tubes that surround the furnace, just like in the combined design. However, the convective section here is made up of water tube bundles connected between two smaller drums, a steam drum on top and a mud drum underneath. In this type of boiler, water flows inside the tubes and flue gas passes outside the tubes. All the auxiliary equipment, including the fuel feeding system, the combustion chamber beneath the fluidized bed, the economizer, air preheater, cyclone dust collector, baghouse filter, blower fans, feed water system, and chimney, are essentially the same in both types of boilers. There is no major difference in terms of supporting systems. The key difference lies entirely in the design of the convective heat transfer section. In one design, you have fire tubes with hot flue gas flowing inside the tubes, which are submerged in water. In the other, you have water tubes with flue gas flowing outside, and the tubes are connected between two smaller drums. Now, when should we use the one-drum fire tube design, and when should we use the two-drum water tube design? Allow me to share a bit of my personal experience in learning about boilers, which dates back to 2002. Back when I was still a student, majoring in thermal engineering at Hanoi University of Science and Technology, I was fortunate to be guided in my boiler graduation project by two professors. One of them had studied in Europe, and the other had studied in China. According to the European textbooks and design standards, for industrial boilers with capacities under 50 tons per hour and pressures below 25 bar, the preferred solution is often the combined fire tube and water tube boiler because it offers simple construction, high heat transfer efficiency, and is easy to clean and maintain. On the other hand, Russian and Chinese technical literature tend to favor the two-drum water tube boiler design, as it is highly compact and can be manufactured across a wide range of capacities and pressures. So I became familiar with both types of boilers as a student, and I even wrote my graduation thesis comparing the two designs. At that time, we also had the chance to operate a 4-ton per hour boiler that had been built and tested at the experimental workshop of the Institute of Thermal Engineering, which gave us incredibly valuable hands-on experience with this boiler technology at a very early stage. Later on, after graduating, I joined a company in southern Vietnam, one that was founded by my former professor, and I began working there from 2007 until now. Back in those days, coal was the dominant fuel used in boilers. It was cheap, had high calorific value, and offered strong steam generating performance. I had the chance to work with a wide variety of industrial boilers in southern Vietnam during that time. At the time, Chinese-made boilers had already flooded the Vietnamese market, especially the compact two-drum water tube boilers. They had a very small and lightweight design, which made them easy to package and ship, ideal for international logistics and container transport. But back then, the level of understanding in Vietnam regarding boiler water treatment and boiler operation was still quite limited. Most factories simply installed the boilers, loaded fuel, turned on the fan, and that was it. Things like proper water treatment, blowdown, and internal cleaning were often overlooked. As a result, these water tube boilers degraded very quickly, particularly because their steam-generating tubes were mostly 51 millimeter in diameter, which is relatively small. Scale formed rapidly on the inner surfaces, causing tube blockages or even tube ruptures, which severely disrupted the customer's production. One of the biggest weaknesses of the traditional two-drum water tube design is that it's very difficult to replace individual tubes in the convective section. When a tube gets damaged, it typically has to be plugged instead of replaced. So over time, as more and more tubes are taken out of service, the boiler's steam output gradually decreases. Once we identified this root cause, we introduced a different solution, the combined water tube and fire tube boiler, to replace the older water tube systems. For the radiant section, we designed larger diameter steam generating tubes, typically F76 mm or F60 mm. This significantly extended the boiler's operational life because it took much longer for scale to build up to critical levels. In addition, if any of the fire tubes in the convective section were damaged, we could replace several of them in less than 2 hours, thanks to a much simpler repair process. That meant our customers could restore production quickly with minimal downtime. Those were some of the key advantages of the fire tube boiler design. However, on the flip side, fire tubes accumulate soot more quickly, which means the boiler needs to be shut down frequently for cleaning. Back then, it was common to shut down the boiler every 2 to 4 weeks just to clean the fire tubes. This posed a real drawback for factories that needed to run continuously all year long without scheduled breaks. But things gradually changed. As the knowledge level of Vietnamese boiler operators improved, people started to understand the importance of proper water treatment and regular blowdown. Thanks to that, scale formation became less of an issue, and the earlier gap between the two boiler types, in terms of scale buildup, started to close. In the following years, another important issue became more apparent: the difference in steam quality between the two designs. The fire tube boiler, with its large single steam drum, produced much drier steam compared to the two-drum water tube boiler, whose upper drum was smaller. This difference in steam dryness became quite obvious. Eventually, ongoing improvements in steam separation internals inside the two-drum boilers helped to gradually resolve this issue. At the same time, the use of proper water treatment chemicals, more optimized feed water systems, and better surface blowdown practices also helped improve steam quality. As a result, the quality of the steam generated by the two boiler types has become increasingly similar. And today, the differences in pros and cons between the two designs are no longer significant. What I've just shared is my personal experience and observations regarding the two types of boilers. One is the combined water tube and fire tube boiler with a large single steam drum, and the other is the two-drum water tube boiler with smaller steam and mud drums. Now let's dive a little deeper into the advantages and disadvantages of these two boiler types. But before that, I'd really appreciate it if you could like, share, and subscribe to the DIVI channel, so you'll be the first to catch our upcoming videos. Let's take a look at this comparison table between the two designs. The first factor is manufacturing cost. In most cases, the cost difference between these two types is minimal. We've manufactured both designs extensively at DIVI, and the overall production cost is nearly the same. As for pressure tolerance, both designs can be used safely and effectively for boilers with operating pressure below 25 bar and capacity below 50 tons per hour. So within this range, either design is suitable. However, when it comes to pressures above 25 bar and capacities over 50 tons, then the two-drum water tube boiler becomes the recommended, and in fact, the preferred option. For this higher pressure segment, the pure water tube boiler is definitely the top choice. Now let's talk about boiler efficiency. At DIVI, we've built and tested both designs, and we found that the overall thermal efficiency is nearly identical. In fact, the fire tube design may perform slightly better due to the more efficient convective heat exchange section. Let me explain with a simple analogy. Imagine a hot water shower system at home. It usually has two outlets. One is a regular faucet that releases water in a large stream. The other is a shower head that splits the water into many small jets. If we deliver the same volume of hot water at the same temperature to both outlets and measure the temperature right as it comes out, we'll find that the water from the shower head feels cooler than the water from the faucet. Why is that? Because the shower head breaks the water into fine droplets, and those droplets lose heat to the surrounding air more quickly. So even though the water is technically the same temperature, it feels cooler and actually does lose heat faster. The faucet, on the other hand, delivers a single large stream, which retains heat better since less surface area is exposed to the air. That's why its temperature appears higher when measured, and it feels noticeably hotter. So what does this analogy tell us? The shower head is like the fire tube bundle. It splits the hot flue gas into smaller streams, which transfers heat more efficiently to the water. Meanwhile, the faucet is like the water tube bundle. It allows larger, broader gas flow, so the heat transfer rate is a bit lower. The smaller the fire tubes, the better the heat transfer efficiency. However, there's a trade-off. Smaller tubes get clogged with soot more quickly, which means they require more frequent cleaning. Now, you might be wondering, why can't the water tube bundle also split the flue gas into finer streams like the fire tube design? Well, in the fire tube boiler, the inner diameter of the tubes is typically around F52 mm. In contrast, the spacing between water tubes in the two drum design is significantly wider than the cross-sectional area of 152 tube. As a result, the flue gas flow in the water tube boiler is broader and less restricted, which means its heat transfer rate is lower, though the difference is modest. But here's the key point. This slight difference in heat transfer efficiency can be compensated for by using heat recovery components downstream, like economizers and air preheaters. So in the end, when both designs are properly engineered, the total thermal efficiency of the two boiler types is virtually the same. Now, let me go a bit deeper into the topic of boiler maintenance, ladies and gentlemen. Since all of the auxiliary equipment, aside from the convective heat transfer section, is practically identical in both boiler types, the general maintenance tasks for these components are essentially the same. So today we'll just focus on comparing the convective sections of the two boiler designs. Let's start with the cleaning aspect. For fire tube boilers, all we need is a cleaning rod like this to brush through each tube, and it'll be completely clean. It's quick, simple, and effective. With water tube boilers, we typically use compressed air or a brush stick to spray or sweep through the convective section. However, due to the geometry and arrangement, this method doesn't allow you to fully clean the inner surfaces of each tube. And that's one of the clear disadvantages of the two-drum water tube design. Next is the tube replacement process, in case of damage. With fire tubes, we simply open the smoke chamber door, and with a few basic mechanical steps, cutting and welding, we can replace an entire bundle of fire tubes very easily, or even replace just one or a few specific tubes if needed. In contrast, with the water tube design, it's very difficult, and in many cases impossible, to replace individual tubes in the convective section. If one tube fails, the entire bundle has to be replaced. That process can take several days, making it one of the major drawbacks of the two-drum water tube boiler. That said, things have improved greatly today. Thanks to years of accumulated experience and structured training programs, our teams now operate boilers with well-defined SOPs and strict quality controls. And combined with the fact that steel quality nowadays is much better, these boilers can run for 15 to 20 years before needing a full tube bundle replacement. So this is no longer a major concern in the long run. Now let's talk about soot accumulation. As many of you may already know, the water tube bundle allows for better airflow than the fire tube bundle. Water tubes are usually installed vertically, while fire tubes are placed horizontally. Because of this, fire tube boilers accumulate dust and soot much faster. In fact, when we operated the steam selling project at TH Milk's factory, we only needed to shut down the two water tube boilers for cleaning once every 3 months. But at Tuong'an cooking oil plant, where we used a fire tube boiler, we had to shut it down for convective section cleaning once every month. This was a major pain point for the fire tube design in continuous production environments. However, after managing nearly 20 steam selling projects and deploying hundreds of industrial boilers, we at DIVI have developed a unique technology for online boiler cleaning. Yes, even while the boiler is still in operation. We've successfully applied this method to perform daily soot removal without interrupting production. Thanks to this innovation, our boilers can now run continuously for 6 to 12 months before requiring a shutdown for internal inspection. With this, DIVI has eliminated the risk of performance loss due to soot buildup inside the boiler. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is my complete answer to the question. I hope this helped you understand more clearly the differences between the water tube and fire tube boiler designs. By now, you've probably grasped the strengths and weaknesses of both types. The only thing left is to choose the technology that gives you peace of mind, along with a reliable supplier that you can trust. I truly look forward to receiving your questions. They are what motivate me to continue sharing my experiences and knowledge about boilers. Please feel free to leave your questions in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.